about 5 or 6 deer around that way. I hear them. They know it's cool. I'm hearing like train tracks or something. I didn't know there was train tracks over that way. Anyways, I just wanted to share this experience. A lot of artificial noises. And yeah, I was feeling, I don't know, a little off being in a town setting in the city. But as soon as I started calming my mind, calming my thoughts about nature and the natural world, just this upliftment, like, so yeah. There's some turkeys. I just wanted to remind you guys that this is available to you whenever you so choose to just allow the natural world to reattune. To reattune with it. Remind you of this inner nature that's available to you. This is awesome. Just like a natural little obstacle course. I was jogging and I saw all this. I'm like, oh yeah, there's so many options. That's what it's all about. Seeing the options that we have available to us. A lot of times we don't realize that they're available to us, some of the options, until maybe we see it in a different perspective. That's why a lot of things we may have been taught to see as objects, but or obstructions. And we may have a response to that. agitation, frustration, anxiety even. But after we learn how to utilize these things that have been gifted to us and choose to see them in a different way, to essentially integrate with a sense of play and enjoyment, then what was previously seen as maybe an annoyance or obstacle can actually liberate us, can help us find another layer of freedom and expression. So no matter what seems to be going on, or is going on for you, realize that you have the power to choose how you want to let anything affect you. That all stems from within. It's all reflected back to us, what we are agreeing with inside of us. So recognize the agreements within, and that will change the perception of what you have agreed upon as reality. And enjoy it. Enjoy the process. Okay, we'll see if it stays here. Okay, so is it necessary to do this? No, nature will take care of itself. It will always flow and work itself out one way or another. But sometimes we can help the growth process a little bit. It's kind of like pruning. So some of these fallen trees are weighing down and potentially causing impedances in the growth process of other plants and trees. So in that case, we can help out a little bit. Never too much, though. Remember that nature has its ways and its patterns of growth. And doing too much oftentimes, you go towards the end of not benefiting as much as allowing things to work themselves out. he was caught. I didn't realize that went all the way. Freedom! It's fucking cold as balls, so he's a little frigid, but he'll straighten right out. So this is something I like to do. I don't really like to use the word sun gazing anymore. It's just sun communing, really. Integrating, absorbing, but also reflecting back in kind. But I like to do them upside down. Either handstand or headstand. It's good times. Okay, so with some of that pranayama, we can engage the bandhas or the locks. And this is strengthening our seals. See, a lot of people, they have a lot of energetic leaks, and that attracts another kind of energy, parasitic, vampiric energies. So when we strengthen, it's kind of like a cellular wall. You can think of it as like another density, the outer shield, the auric shield. When we start to clean up our diet and engage breath work, communion, and connection with nature, not only does it strengthen and rejuvenate the physical body, but also all the subtle bodies. So yes, with empowered seals, we can start to handle more pressures, not just physically, energetically, but mentally, because all of our bodies are tied in, interconnected and interrelatable. And then also I wanted to say, whenever I have my hands over my eyes and allowing the after image of the sun that's kind of burned in there, allowing that to become more and more clear and vibrant, focusing on that, that type of focus and mental training will also translate into your ability to focus more clearly within your dreams, to a lucid dream, to be able to stay within the dream easier and focus on that kind of subtleness. And you can also do that with a flame and stare into a flame and then focus on the after image. And that focus is all like meditation, and the meditation translates into how we meditate and mediate throughout all waking life, dream world, melding the two. So yes, focus, training, seals. And always quality over quantity. It's the focus that really matters here. Ground's still a little wet and cold, but feels so good. Oh, look at these little guys. These guys usually come up right around or a little bit before a lot of the mushrooms come up here. And as you can tell, it's been pretty freaking cold here lately. They're so cold and delicate. But they are ready to adapt and transform very quickly.